For 12 years, Eleanor was addicted to heroin, cocaine and alcohol. But she's one of the lucky ones who's been able to kick the habit. She says addiction almost ruined her life.
It just became worse and I was constantly searching for the sort of perfect cocktail of drugs.
What sort of physical and emotional effect did all this have on your life?
Emotionally, it got to the point where there didn't really seem much point in going on. And it was a very hopeless, unmanageable lifestyle.
Philip is another former addict. 17 years of drug and alcohol addiction almost cost him his life.
Well, at the end of my active addiction, I was feeling like committing suicide. I was in total despair because everything had fallen to pieces around me.
It's estimated that 250,000 people in Britain are now addicted to drugs. One new initiative is this clinic in North London. It's the first in the capital to use a unique method of counselling sufferers. Most others rely on drug substitutes. It's been set up by former alcoholic John Wallace, who put his life savings into the project. With special evening sessions, the centre will allow addicts to continue working.
This is group therapy on the Minnesota model. It involves one-to-one counselling, group therapy counselling, lectures, behavioural change, basically.
But it's not only drug addiction that's worrying health experts. One in three of the population are addicted to cigarettes. 700,000 have alcohol problems. That's why a new charity, Action on Addiction, was launched today. It hopes to raise £6 million to open the country's first centre to research and come up with ways of helping to solve the problem.
We've got to have a centre which is a catalyst for action on a national scale to deal across the board with problems related to alcohol, tobacco, tranquilizers, heroin, the whole lot.
The new charity will target industry now said to be losing £4 billion a year in lost production because of addiction. Many addicts have already lost their jobs.
I lost my business, I nearly lost my family, and I lost the ability to live a healthy life, really.
With one in five of the population now said to be addicted to drugs, alcohol or cigarettes, today's new initiatives are clearly needed. This is Mike Pearce for Thames News.